Cinderella lived with her wicked stepmother and two wicked stepsisters. They were not nice to Cinderella at all. They made her do all the work while they went out each day visiting their friends. The stepmother was trying to find each of her daughters a suitable husband. Cinderella had no friends except for the creatures in and around her house. Her friends included a cat, a dog, the only horse they had, the birds, and, oh yes, the mice. One day a messenger delivered an invitation to the king's ball. It was to be a ball to find the prince a wife who would fit in as queen when the prince became king. The wicked stepmother and stepsisters were very excited about going, and they soon had Cinderella waiting on them to help get them ready. They never even considered Cinderella going to the ball. They were all interested in themselves and couldn't care about Cinderella or her feelings. She just didn't matter to them. The day of the ball, Cinderella got out the only party dress she had. It wasn't very pretty, but she did the best she could to make it presentable. Then her wicked stepmother and stepsisters laughed and made fun of her, and her stepsisters pushed and shoved her and tore her dress into pieces so that Cinderella couldn't wear it. Her stepmother told her the only way she could go to the ball was if her work was done and she had a nice dress to wear. Cinderella ran out to her garden and cried and cried. The time came for the ball and everyone left except for Cinderella. She was still in her garden when suddenly her fairy godmother appeared.
"Who are you?"
Cinderella asked. "I'm your fairy godmother, and I'm here to help you get ready for the ball," she said. Cinderella began to cry and said,
"I can't go. I don't have a thing to wear."
Her fairy godmother said, "That's why I'm here. I have a dress all ready for you with matching accessories, including these glass slippers, and I can even have your hair a new look. I also have a carriage ready, and all you have to do is be back here before the stroke of midnight. If you don't come back before then, your new dress will become your old dress, and your carriage will become a pumpkin again. Your horses will become mice again, and, well, it won't be a pretty sight." Soon Cinderella was stepping into the ballroom, and everyone turned to see who that beautiful young woman was. The wicked stepmother and stepsisters didn't even recognize her. The prince took one look and could not look at anyone else the rest of the night. They danced every dance together. The prince was about to ask her to marry him when the town clock started to strike midnight. Cinderella realized she should have already been back at home, and she turned and ran as fast as she could, losing one of her slippers. The prince found it, but he couldn't find Cinderella. The next day, the prince and his assistant searched the entire town for his new love until he came upon Cinderella's house. They knocked on the door, and when the wicked stepmother answered it, she invited them in. The prince asked to see any daughters that may live there in hopes of finding his true love. The wicked stepsisters tried on the glass slipper, but neither could fit her foot into it. The prince asked if there were any other daughters living in their house. The wicked stepmother started to tell the prince that no one else lived there when Cinderella opened the back door and came in. The prince tried to hand the glass slipper to Cinderella when the wicked stepmother reached out to grab it and knocked it to the floor. The slipper broke into a million pieces, but Cinderella pulled the other glass slipper from her apron pocket and said,
"That's okay, stepmother. I have the other slipper."
She put on the other slipper, and the prince kissed her right on the lips because he knew he had found his one true love. The next day, the prince and Cinderella were married, and they lived happily ever after.